Welcome to Managing Metrics, a series of videos highlighting contact center metrics that matter to managers. I'm Bruce Belfiore, CEO of Benchmark Portal, here to talk to you about call volume metrics. In this video, we will define these metrics, talk about why they are important, and how they're determined. This video is brought to you by Benchmark Portal, the source for contact center training, certification, benchmarking, and consulting. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the like button, which will allow us to continue providing you with valuable, free educational content just like this. Volumetrics sometimes cause confusion for contact center managers. I will set out some simple concepts which you can trace back to your ACD reports to provide numbers that are accurate and benchmarkable for your operation. Since understanding and predicting volumes are essential for workforce management, and are also keys to understanding how well you are dealing with incoming calls, these metrics are important to master and monitor. We start with calls offered. This is the total number of calls of all types which are directed to a contact center by callers. Calls offered should not be mistaken with calls offered to the agent queue, a metric which takes only the volume of calls which go through the IVR and are then offered to, that is, routed to, the agent queue. A quick word on an old metric, blocked calls. These are calls that hit a busy signal and never get admitted to the ACD. Busy signals are, of course, big dissatisfiers, and the cost of telephone lines is now so low in most countries that it's rarely a problem these days. To find out if you have blocked calls, you should check with your telephony supplier. It's a good idea to get this information, if only to confirm that all calls offered to you are indeed getting through. The next metric we look at is calls handled. These are calls that are actually answered and serviced by your center. The difference between calls offered and calls handled should pretty much equal calls abandoned. However, we often see slight differences in the numbers coming from some reporting systems. This is either due to rounding differences or to having a parameter coded into your ACD that, for example, will not count calls as abandoned if they are dropped by the caller in less than 7 seconds or something similar. Calls handled are divided into two categories. The first is the volume of calls handled without human intervention. These are calls that are resolved entirely within the IVR and through use of virtual agents, also called bots and other names. These vary in sophistication, with the more advanced versions using artificial intelligence and machine learning to increase their success. The percentage of calls handled without human intervention is rising and represents well over half of calls handled across all industries, according to our metrics database. The second category, of course, is the volume of calls handled by agents. These are calls that are routed to the agent queue either directly or following a failure of an automated system to resolve the caller's issue. The percentage of calls handled completely without a human agent is sometimes called the containment rate and is calculated by taking the total number of calls handled by the IVR and other automated means divided by the total number of calls handled. This metric is an important efficiency or cost-related metric. It makes logical sense that the more contacts are handled by machines, the fewer agents you will need to employ, and the lower your costs will be to run the center. Let's consider a simple example. Say you have a total annual volume of calls handled by your dedicated phone agents of 2,410,000 and an average cost per agent handled call of $3.66. Imagine you are currently handling 40% of calls in the IVR and want to increase that to 50%. A change of 10% of your call volume. If you were able to improve your IVR functionality and cause an additional 10% of call volume to resolve successfully in the IVR, the math would look as follows. 10% of calls, 241,000 calls. Cost per call, $3.66. Savings on agent handled calls would be just over $882,000. Most IVR improvement costs and operating costs are fairly modest, which would provide you with an excellent ROI for your efforts. It should be noted, however, that no one is predicting the elimination of human agents at this point in time. There are still high volumes that require a human agent to resolve, And it is also true that many customers simply prefer to talk to a human agent to resolve their issue. We see some quality-focused centers who are cautious about moving their volumes to automated options. During our management certification and workforce management certification courses, we offer techniques and tools that will help you determine exactly what your volumes are for each channel, how each affects your budget, cost per transaction per channel, and how to determine where to spend your energy and money to improve service for your customers and financial results for your company. And now, questions for you on your contact volume metrics. Have your overall volumes been rising or falling in recent years? Where do you see the volume of calls contained in your automated systems going in the next few years, and why? Please write your answer and any other comments below. We'd love for you to share your thoughts and ideas with the community of contact center experts who regularly visit us here. You can also find links to some of our other valuable resources in the description below. And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to get great content delivered to you. Good luck managing your call volumes.